my first experience, it was a very personal one. Knowing that I was going to be a part of a company, ICI as an organization and what their mission and vision is, their belief system is very closely related to mine, actually, in believing in social and independent inclusion of people with intellectual developmental disabilities.
I actually started as Ashley's supervisor, I think it was 4 years ago now, on the Choosing Employment Project. Over the course of that project, our relationship actually evolved from a traditional supervisor-supervisee relationship, and now we have a mentor-mentee relationship, and Ashley actually has another supervisor at ICI.
One of the great things about working with Ashley is she's not shy about asking questions. She's really good at the qualitative research that we do and looking at data and developing themes and being critical and analyzing that data. She's going to be taking the lead on conducting some interviews. And as we do them, she's also going to be looking at key aspects of those interviews and developing themes and analyzing them.
This is a very interesting type of research because it's focusing on human research and human social behavior. You have to know what you're doing. You have to be sensitive and smart with that. You have to get trained within the ethical boundaries. You're dealing with human subjects. You're dealing with human people. You have to know how to work with that. I did it. And so I got through with that, I passed the ethics test. I have no intention of leaving the field because this is what I do, is what I believe in, is what I love.
We wanted to make sure that we were making every aspect of the research project inclusive so that Ashley could be included in all of the decision making, just as any other team member at ICI would be on a research project.
I hope that Ashley can continue to expand some of her roles and responsibilities here at the Institute for Community Inclusion. I really feel like she brings a lot to the table, both in her expertise and also in her background, you know, in some of the other projects that she's worked on. Her content knowledge is really good.
People with intellectual developmental disability or any other type can do any kind of work. It doesn't matter. As long as they can, you know, perform the job functions and being accommodated for, being supported within the job itself, the workplace, the employer, knowing how to work with them. Don't discriminate just because the individual has a disability. It doesn't mean they can't work. You have to give them what they need so they can be at their best.